I want you to imagine that you are on a journey and you are in a car. What if I were to ask you to make a comparison of this journey, this very same journey, with the journey that you're on now in Live Lead? Right? The same journey that we're on. Live Lead is that journey. The destination is your objective for being here. And your companions in that car would be the participants who are here. And that car is the breakout rooms that we're often put in. And the weather, not so great for traveling. I would liken it to having to meet each other and to communicate virtually. Now, my dear friends, my dear young Lasallians, my question to you is, what sort of companion have you been on this journey so far? So my invitation to you today is to step up and decide what sort of companion would you like to be in today's session and for the rest of this Live Lead program. So that's my first challenge to you. Because as we move along on this topic about knowing others and working together. Now, you see, we either get to know people, then decide we want to work with them, or we are put in situations where we work with them and then we get to know them. And maybe sometimes when we get to know them, we may not want to work with them anymore. It could work in various ways. But I see that these two elements have a relationship, a correlation, right? You know others, and when you're talking about being in this mission, it is about working with others. Now, you have been given this time limit so that you know how to manage your time. Now, dear friends, this is essential as we work with others and we work on projects. Every project has a time frame. So now my question to you, in your discussions, however long, however short they were you fully present? Listening is a whole body mind experience. And I wanted to bring in that aspect of listening because I think in our journey on this Lasallian mission, this journey on as being Lasallians, where we look at the three values of faith, right? Service and community. The faith that tells us why. It's important for us to know why we do the things we do. The service, being rooted in that faith, it helps me think about how can I express my faith? How can I live out these friendships that I have formed? In what way? And you look at the fruits here, that's the fruits of our labor. And who do we labor with? It is the community. Right, we work together as a community. The service industry, the mission, anything that is service related involves connection, involves relationship, involves working together. And research has also shown, right? Research has also shown that people generally tend to work better and achieve greater success in working together as in teams. We're going to look at what are the elements that support us on this journey of working together? And what are the elements that hinder us from working together? Now, it's very easy for us to always point the finger at the other guy. But as my good friend Michael Jackson says, you start with the man in the mirror. That is where our journey of growth begins. What is my contribution to this working relationship? What am I doing that's stopping this relationship from growing, from developing? So self-care is another area that's important, right? So lack of self-care could also hinder you from being a team player. So I hope that you would be able to later on consider the impact that these elements have on how you work with others. One person who encountered similar challenges in working with others. Our founder, St. John Baptist de La Salle. What I'd like to draw your attention to is, what did he do, right? What did he do in the face of these challenges? He continued to believe in his work. and what he was called to do. He continued responding to a need. He listened to the needs of the children on the street. He listened to the needs of his teachers, right? His teachers who were not trained, who didn't come from affluent families like he did. He responded to a point of going out of his way to help and support them, even to a point of moving in with them. Although he did take time to retreat, to reflect, to recollect, a journey of knowing others and working together, I personally have found that need for respite, for quiet time's journey. And St. John Baptist de La Salle set a plan in motion. He took that heroic vow and formed the Order of the Brothers. He just didn't want to leave things as they were. He built something that was sort of a structure that would carry on, that would continue his legacy 300 years on. And we're all gathered here because of one man who persevered, who in spite of the challenges was determined because he believed in what he was doing. His beliefs were rooted in his faith, right? His belief was rooted in his faith. So I hope that we'll always come back to this example, that each one of us does have a style, a different style. And each style has its good and it has its shortcoming. And that is going to be your journey. So what is it that you need to do? It's doing a reflection like this to help identify what are the things that I appreciate about this working style that can complement my working style. So this, my dear friends, is a challenge. It's a challenge when you work with people. And people, as we are all organic, we are authentic, we are made in the image of God, we are all made to be different. And that poses one of the greatest challenges in working with each other. And I think it's also one of the greatest blessings, because if we can see and we can appreciate these differences, that's when we can move ahead together as a mission. I would like to leave you with this important message from the Institute, our worldwide La Salle organization, to remember that you, my dear friends, are part of a miracle. Each one of us here is part of that miracle. Each one of us here is an important member.